In the previous video, we learned how to take the joint screw axes S1 to SN, defined in the space frame S when the robot is at the zero configuration, and transform them to the N columns of the space Jacobian at any arbitrary joint configuration theta. In this video, we construct the 6x N body Jacobian JB from the screw axes B1 to BN, expressed in the end effector frame B. The body Jacobian transforms joint velocities to the body twist. To derive the body Jacobian JB, let's use the 5R arm from the previous video as an example. To derive JB, we need to define the end effector frame B, but we don't need an S frame. JB has 5 columns, one for each joint, and in this video we will focus on JB3, the third column, corresponding to the end effector twist when joint 3 moves with unit velocity. First, we set all joint angles equal to 0. At this configuration, JB3 is just B3, the screw axis of joint 3 expressed in the B frame when the arm is at its 0 configuration. Now we rotate joint 1. Notice that this rotation of joint 1 does not change the relationship between joint 3 and the B frame, so JB3 is still equal to B3. Now we rotate joint 2. Again, the relationship between joint 3 and the B frame is unaffected by joint 2's motion, so JB3 is still equal to B3. Now we rotate joint 3. As with joints 1 and 2, JB3 is unaffected by joint 3's motion. Now we rotate joint 4 by theta 4. This motion changes the configuration of joint 3 relative to the B frame, so JB3 changes. We define the frame B double prime to be the B frame before joint 4 is rotated, and the frame B prime to be the B frame after joint 4 is rotated. The relationship between the two is given by TB double prime B prime equals e to the bracket B4 times theta 4. We define the B double prime frame because the screw axis for joint 3 is just B3 in this frame. Finally, we rotate joint 5 by theta 5, giving us the final end effector frame B, obtained by rotating the frame B prime about the joint 5 screw axis by theta 5. To find the B frame relative to the B double prime frame, we post-multiply TB double prime B prime by the body frame transformation corresponding to rotation about the body screw axis B5, giving us the equation shown here. What we really want, though, is the configuration of the B double prime frame relative to the B frame, so we reverse the subscripts, which is the same as taking the inverse of the transformation matrix. Making use of the fact that the inverse of A times B, where A and B are invertible matrices, is just B inverse times A inverse, we can write TB B double prime in this form. Since the screw axis of joint 3 is just B3 in the B double prime frame, to find JB3, we just need to use our rule for changing the frame of reference of a twist. The final expression for the JB3 column depends on the screw axis for joint 3, as well as the joint angles and screw axes for joints 4 and 5. The same reasoning applies for any joint, so we can generalize to this definition of the body Jacobian JB. The last column of the body Jacobian is just the screw axis BN when the robot is at its zero configuration. It does not depend on the joint positions because no joint is between joint N and the B frame. Any other column I of the body Jacobian is given by the screw axis BI pre-multiplied by the transformation that expresses the screw axis in the B frame for arbitrary joint positions. You can see that JB1 depends on the positions of joints 2 through N, JB2 depends on the positions of joints 3 through N, etc. You can also see that the body Jacobian is independent of the choice of the space frame S. Since each column of a Jacobian is a twist, we can use our rule for representing a twist in a different frame to translate between the space Jacobian JS and the body Jacobian JB. JB is obtained from JS by the matrix adjoint of TBS, and JS is obtained from JB by the matrix adjoint of TSB. In the next video, we'll see that the Jacobian is used not only to convert joint velocities to end effector twists, but also to understand how end effector wrenches are related to torques and forces at the joints.